Gravity is not the only thing that affects all of us equally. There's another thing which affects the young, the old, the skinny, the fat, the educated, the ignorant. It's one thing that causes grown men to bawl, that causes stress to build up and divorce rates to keep going up. Money. Everyone wants it. But only 5% of the population has it. The rest of the 95% live a life of struggle with finances. And why is that? Why is that only 5 out of every 100 people make it? This is the first of our money series where we will look at precisely this issue. We will look to see how you can put more money in your pockets and what are the changes you need to make to push that needle. Hi, I'm Sheila and this is Lumiere 24. Light on. My own struggles with money and abundance caused me to educate myself about money. I realized that while we learn to read and write by the time we are 5 and taught to earn a living by the time we are 25, we have never, ever been taught how to create wealth and financial independence. And it seems we are forever in a fight with lack in our life. Here, I would like to use the analogy of a tree. A tree is so symbolic of ourselves and anything that happens in our life. The leaves are the reality of whatever is going on right now. If we are to take the example of money, what is your current reality? Too much debt, don't own my own house, not making as much money as I want, I'm working too hard for the money I'm making, running and running to stay in the same place. These are all leaves. And just like any tree, when you keep plucking off the leaves, what happens? The tree just grows new leaves, which is why your situation never seems to change. The branches represent the common emotions attached to these issues in our life. So again, in this case, it could be stress, anxiety, fear, impatience, even anger and frustration. Take your pick. What are your branches? The trunk represents the important events that may have affected your money story. Ask yourself what your experience was like growing up with money. Do you remember your parents telling you money doesn't grow on trees? Do you know how much your college costs? Do you remember your mom saying, I have no money, ask daddy? What about the dread of money running out before the end of the month? What about storming out of the house, the raised voices, the arguments? What makes up the trunk of your money tree? You will notice that eliminating the leaves or the branches or even the trunk does not change the situation. The tree simply grows back to what it was. If you want a different tree, you need to change the roots. And what makes up the roots of this tree? These are the beliefs we have around money. Our money blueprint, and for that matter, any blueprint, is set by the time we are 7 years old. Surprising, isn't it? We are living the stories that we have absorbed from our surroundings as we grew up. These beliefs are the seeds that are planted, creating the root of your tree. So ask yourself, how do I feel about money? Do I believe rich people are mean? That money is the root of all evil? Is it easy to make money? Is it easy to be fulfilled in what I do? Am I good with it? Do I believe that I cannot make money with the things I love? Is it safe to stand out and be successful? Does being more successful mean I'll have to do more work? Am I scared of failing? Am I scared of succeeding? Do I feel plain unlucky and that it is probably my karma to be poor in this lifetime? Is it not spiritual to make money? I believe my stars are not aligned and that Saturn is in the 8th house and Mercury is in my 5th. These have ruined my chances of ever becoming rich. The only way lasting change can happen is by uprooting the wrong tree that doesn't support you and planting new seeds. After all, shaking an apple tree and saying, give me oranges does not help, right? I'm committed to seeing you make the shift. So today, I'm going to hand over the first of my many tools that I have in Sheila's Toolbox. This one is called the money flashlight. We have to shine this light in the dark spaces of our mind where these fellas, these disempowering beliefs about money lurk. Like all monsters, they are the bravest in the dark. So shine the bright flashlight and hunt them out. So what beliefs hold you back? Money affects relationships. Love is more important than money. Money is the root of all evil. My father was poor, my grandfather was poor, my great-grandfather was poor. It's not for people like me. I'm not good with money. In this video, click on the button that you will see, which will take you to a downloadable template of over 100 money beliefs that I have compiled to make it easier for you. To do this exercise, you will need 10 to 15 minutes of uninterrupted time. Ideally, read each belief out aloud and rate how true it feels on a scale of 0 to 10, with 10 being completely true and 0 being not true at all. For each limiting belief that you rate, for instance, I'm not good with money, you will then rate a related empowering belief, I'm good with money, according to how true it feels to you on a scale of 0 to 10. Do this exercise now. It is one of the first exercises that my workshop participants do before we proceed further. Because you know this by now, awareness is the first step to change. I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment below. Tell me, what does your tree look like? If you would like help in changing your tree, you know you can reach out to me. Like and share this video with as many of your friends and family members as you can. Even your bosses, wow, promotion, colleagues or subordinates. Remember, when the tide rises, all boats rise. And subscribe now to receive such life hacks and more in your inbox. Spread the light, folks.